Now, seventh problem we will see. A local cricket team played 20 matches in one season. Okay, then if it won 25% of them and lost rest and last rest, how many matches did it lose? How many matches did it lose? Okay, observe the given problem carefully. Here they have mentioned that the total number of games, matches played by the cricket team is equal to 20. A local cricket team played 20 matches in one season. Total number of matches is equal to 20. Out of that, if it won 25%, means number of win, percentage of winning games are 25. And last rest, remaining percentage of games was lost. That means out of 100%, only 25 they won the games. Remaining all are lasted games, yes or no? Means 100 minus 25, 75% of games were lost. Now, how many matches did it lose? 75% of 20 games were lose, yes or no? So, percentage means you can find out percentage first after that number of games it lose. Otherwise, percentage of games it won, after that subtract from 20. Two methods we can do. So, first what I am doing? Given, with the given values I am doing first. Given, total matches is equal to 20. Okay, and percentage of won matches is equal to 25%. Percentage given, so number of won games, won matches find out. Therefore, number of won matches is equal to 25% of total games. Yes or no? 25% of 20. So, what we will get? 25, remove the percentage by dividing with 100. Remove half, that is into 20. Okay, 20 ones are 25s are, 5 ones are, 5 fives are 25. 5 games it is won, means remaining games it is lose. That means total games are 20, out of 25 games only won. So remaining how many games are there? 15. Therefore, number of lost matches is equal to total games minus won games, that is equal to 15. Okay, this is one way. Otherwise, so second, what are they game? Total matches is equal to 20. And percentage of won matches is equal to 25. Therefore, first find out percentage. Percentage of lost matches is equal to total percentage is 100. 100 minus 25. So, which is equal to 75%. Okay. 75%. 75% it lost. Therefore, number of matches lost is equal to 1 and number of matches lost. So number of matches lost is equal to this one. Number of matches lost is equal to 75% of total games, 20. So that is nothing but 75/100 into 20. 20 ones are 25, 5 ones are 5, 15 are. So totally 15 games it is lost. Either first you can find out percentage, after that value. Otherwise, find out the percentage of won games and subtract to get the value of lost games. Anyway, we can do this problem. Okay. So remember here, this question, given percentage is for won games and asking the number of matches it lose. So first we can percentage of lost games, lost matches, and after that how many games it is lost, like this. Otherwise, first we can find out with the percentage and total value how many matches it is won, after that number of matches it is lost. So two methods are correct. Whatever you want to follow, that is correct only. Now coming to the next eighth problem. In every gram of gold, in every gram of gold, a goldsmith mixes 0.25 grams grams of silver and 0.05 grams of copper . What is the percentage of gold, silver and copper in every gram of gold? Observe the problem. In every gram of gold, a goldsmith mixes 0.25 grams of silver. Means how much he is mixing silver given, and 0.05 grams of copper. But what about gold? They did not mention. Just observe here. In every gram, means for one gram of gold, they are mixing 0.25 grams of silver, 0.05 grams of copper. Total three materials he is mixing to prepare an ornament. One is gold, silver, copper. For total mixture, he is using for 1 gram. 1 gram, he is mixing silver of 0.25 grams and 0.05 grams of copper. So remaining portion is for gold only, sir. No, remaining part of the whatever mixture is there, that is related, belongs to gold only. So remaining how much is there? Now just observe, 0.25 plus 0.05, that is 0.30. total 1 gram gold is there. 1 gram gold is 1.00 grams. So in this 0.30 is used for silver and copper. Now remaining is 10 minus 3 is 7. And here 0 will get 0.70, means gold, quantity of gold used, weight of gold used in the ornament for 1 gram is 0.70 and it is 0.05. Now we have what quantity, means how much quantity is used for 1 gram of gold, that is gold, silver and copper. Now they are asking percentage of gold. So quantity of gold is 0.70 out of total is 1.00 grams into 100. Otherwise, this is a decimal number. We need to convert into percentage. So multiply with 100, that's it. Given total weight of total quantity of mixture, whatever mixture is given, that is equal to 1 gram. In that, they have given that quantity of actually weight. So weight we will write. Weight of silver in that mixture will be equal to 0.25 grams given. And weight of copper is equal to 0.05 grams. And listen, in that mixture he is mixing gold, copper and silver. Therefore, weight of gold is equal to total weight 1 gram minus 1 minus 0.25 plus 0.05 grams. Okay, actually total weight is gold plus silver plus copper is equal to total weight. So we want like that only, right? Otherwise, total weight is equal to weight of gold plus silver plus copper. So total weight we have 1 gram. As a decimal number only I am writing, 1.00 grams is equal to weight of gold we need to find. And silver we have 0.25 grams and it is 0.05 grams. So total is 0.30. Weight of gold will be equal to 1.00 minus 0.30 grams, which is equal to 0.70 grams. Okay, therefore, percentage of silver is equal to percentage of gold is equal to 0.70 grams into 100, which is equal to 70%. And percentage of, because it is decimal number, we are converting into percentage. Percentage of silver is equal to 0.25 into 100. It is 25%. And percentage of copper equal to 0.05 into 100, so which is equal to 5%. So like this also you can do. Otherwise, first you are finding how much weight is used in that ornament or whatever. Like this we are finding the percentage. Otherwise, first go through with the percentage of silver, then we will get 25%. Percentage of copper is 5%, then total percentage is 100. Out of 100, 25 plus 5 is used for silver and copper. So 25 plus 5 is 30. 100 minus 30 is 70% of gold is used in that. Okay, that's all. Okay, just observe this same question. We can do in other way also. Observe this. So here they are given weight of silver and weight of copper. Total weight of the mixture is equal to 1 gram. So first of all, find out the percentage of silver and percentage of copper. Percentage of silver is equal to 0.25 into 100, which is equal to 25%. Two zeros, two decimal digits, both will get cancelled, and next point will get cancelled. Okay, percentage of copper is equal to 0.05 into 100, which is equal to 0.5 will get. That is nothing but 5%. Therefore, percentage of gold is equal to 100% minus percentage of these two materials. That is 25% plus 5%. So, which is equal to 100 minus 30, which is nothing but 70%. So like this also we can do same question. Okay, now coming to the last problem. Last question is 40% of a number is 800. Then find the number. Okay, this is. Okay, observe the question. 40% of a number is 800. So let that number as a x. Let the required number as a x. Then given 40% of a number, that number we have taken as x, is equal to, is means is equal to 800. 40% of number is 800. So 40% of x equal to 800 is given in the statement. Okay, therefore remove percentage, what will get? 40 by 100, half means into x is equal to 800. So while you are bringing one fraction to other side, we need to take reciprocal. As that means 100 will come into the numerator, 40 will come into the denominator. Why? Because here it is division, in 100 is in division operation with x, 40 is in multiplication, so both will interchange. X will be equal to 800, because it is in division, it will comes into the multiplication, and because it is in multiplication with x, while we are transforming, it will become division. So reciprocal of 40 by 100, 100 by 40, then just do the cancelization. What will get? 0 0 will get, 4 ones are 420s are. So we got x is equal to 2000, 20 into 100 means that number is 2000. That's all. So don't confuse. If they are given like this, you are going directly 40% of 800. That is wrong. They are given 40% of a number is 800. So let the number is x. 40% of that number is 800. By simplifying that, you will get the correct answer. With this, all the questions from exercise 4 were finished. Okay, all these questions related to percentages only. Okay, once revise whatever topics we have finished till now in this chapter. So first we are discussed about what is mean by ratio and what are the different terms of ratio. And next topic we have done for proportion. And thirdly we have discussed about direct proportion as well as unitary method. And nextly, we have discussed about percentages. Okay, so last week you got these two topics for exam also, and now remaining topics you are going to get for exam. Now observe what is mean by ratio. Ratio is nothing but comparison of two same quantities using division. Okay, and here we are using A is to B as the general form of a ratio. A is known as antecedent, B is known as consequent or second term, or A is first term, B is the second term. Okay, and proportion. If two ratios are said to be, if two ratios are equal, then they are said to be in proportion. Okay, and before this we have discussed what are equivalent ratios, all those things. So ratio is nothing but comparison of two same quantities using division. A is to B is nothing but A by B only. A is antecedent, B is consequent. And proportion. If two ratios are equal, then they are said to be in proportion. For suppose 3 is to 5 is equal to 6 is to 10. Observe this. 3 2s are 6, 5 2s are 10. Means if I'm multiplying the antecedent with 2 and consequent with 2, I'm getting its equivalent ratio. Yes, so those are said to be equivalent ratios. And two ratios are equal, means two ratios are in proportion, if their product of, so just observe what are the different terms of proportion. We will see one by one now. Ratio is ordered comparison. Okay, means compulsory whatever order they are asking, like that order only we must consider. For suppose they are given number of boys is equal to, boys in a class is equal to 15 and girls is equal to 5. And now if they are asking ratio of boys to girls is equal to 15:5. Number of boys 15, girls 5. We can't write 5:15. Ordered comparison. So here 15:5 is not in the lowest form. Convert into simplest form. Why? Because both can cancel in 5 table. See that cancelization. 5 divided by 5 is 5/5. 5 ones are 5 threes are 5 ones are 5 threes are 5 ones are, which is equal to 3:1. See, by dividing antecedent and consequent, we are getting 3:1. 3:1 equivalent ratio of 15:5. Means 15:5 is equal to 3:1. I am telling. If two ratios are said to be equal, then they are said to be in proportion. And proportion, we are combining two ratios, yes or no? So one ratio having two terms, antecedent and consequent, whereas two ratios are there. So here four terms are there. That means in proportion we are getting four terms. First term and fourth term are known as extremes. Second and third terms are known as means. And if the two ratios are said to be in proportion, they must satisfy the condition. Product of extremes is equal to product of means. Otherwise, product of means is equal to product of extremes. How we are doing that? 5 threes are 15, 15 ones are 15. See, product of extremes is 15 and 1. 15:1 = 15. And for means, 5 and 3 are means. Product of those two numbers is equal to 5 threes are 15. That's all. Depending on this, we have several problems. If any one term is missing in this, any one term, then we are finding by using this condition only for that term. See, first suppose 15:x = 3:1. Here second term is missing. So we are using the condition product of means is equal to product of extremes. That is 3x = 15 ones are 15. So x will be equal to 15/3. 15:1 will get actually. So 3 ones are 3, 5 are. So x value we got 5. Just observe. To find out the missing value in the proportion, we are using the condition product of means is equal to product of extremes. If that condition is satisfied, then only those two ratios are said to be in proportion. If that condition is not satisfied, then they are not in proportion. That's all. That is about ratio and proportion. And next one is the direct proportion or unitary method. Direct proportion and unitary method. Direct proportion in the sense, if the change, see, so consider some situations, then we will understand what is meant by direct proportion. See, first suppose, if you are taking two books, if you are buying two books, cost of those two books, first suppose one book cost is 10 rupees, then two books will be 20 rupees, yes or no? Same type of books, I need four. Then I must pay 4 into 10. One book is 10 rupees, then four books cost is equal to 40 rupees. Means if number of books are increasing, whatever cost I need to pay, whatever price I need to pay for the shopkeeper, that one also increasing. And here, see, when number of books are less, cost is less. Number of books are more, cost is more. Means it is directly proportional. Cost and quantity of the books, number of books are directly proportional. So that is said to be direct proportion. If first suppose I have the question, cost of 6 books is equal to 24 rupees. Then find the cost of, or suppose take pens, find the cost of 12 pens. So it is very simple, because number and cost will be are directly proportion, just we seen. So first of all, arrange them. Quantity, number of pens arrange one side as one ratio, 6:12. 6 pens are 12 pens, and cost of 6 pens is 24 rupees. And cast of 12 pence, we don't know. So let that term as x. Just observe now, they are in proportion. So we can use product of means is equal to product of extremes. Because they are in direct proportion, we are using that that condition. Okay, because they are in direct proportion. So now, what we will get? X will be equal to 12 into 24, actually 6x. 6 and x are extremes. 12 and 24 are means. Product of extremes is equal to product of means. Then x will be equal to 12 into 24 by 6. 6 ones are, 6 fours are. So 12 fours are 48 rupees is the cost of 12 pence. This same question we can do with the unitary method also. So how you are doing by unitary method? First, they are given cost of 6 pence is 24 rupees. Cost of 6 pence is equal to 24 rupees. Then what is the cost of 1 pen? Find out first. Unitary method, in the sense, first we are finding one quantity value, that is cost of 1 pen is equal to 24 by 6 rupees, that is 6 ones are, 6 fours are. So 4 rupees is the cost of 1 pen. Like that, how many pens he want to buy? 12 pens. So cost of 12 pens will be equal to 12 into cost of 1 pen, that is 4 rupees. So 12 fours are 48 rupees is the cost of 12 pence. The method in which we are finding one quantity value after that a required quantity is known as unitary method. So whatever questions we are doing for direct proportion, we can simplify by using unitary method also. Okay. And next, in case of map, scale used in the map and actual distance. In that case also, we are using direct proportion only. Okay, means some whatever distance shown on the map, that is less. Okay, actual distance we will not mention on the map. It is impossible. So for bigger, whatever distance is there, for that we will divide. We will use appropriate scale to draw on the map. Yes or no? That scale is directly proportional to actual length. So depending on that also, we have solved some of the questions. And now one more situation. Speed is equal to distance by time. You know this. That means if your speed is increased, then distance also increasing. Distance covered by whatever vehicle or whatever. More distance you will cover if you are increasing the speed. Means if speed is more, covered distance also more. If speed is less, distance also less. Covered distance also less. So speed and distance are directly proportional. Okay. And coming to time, speed and time. If you are increasing the speed to reach the destination, you will take less time. To reach the destination, you will take less time. Means when you are going with more speed, time consumption will be less. Yes or no? Means they are, if you are going very slowly, then to reach the destination you will take more time. Means when you are increasing the speed, time is becoming less, and when you are decreasing the speed, time required to reach the destination is more. So one is more, one is less. It is comes under indirect proportion. But related to this, we did not talk. But what I am telling, speed is directly proportional to distance, covered distance. Speed is indirectly proportional with the time. And what about distance and time? If you are increasing distance, okay, distance is more, time also we need more. If distance is less, time required to reach that distance will be less. So both are direct proportion, distance and time. If they are given distance and time, direct proportion, speed and distance, direct proportion. If they are given speed and time, that is indirect. But we will not get these questions. We will get speed and distance and distance and time. Distance with speed and time. That's it. And after this, we were discussed about percentages. Okay, so many problems also we have simplified using percentages. Percentage means out of 100 we are calculating whatever. And now just observe, in a class of 25 there are 25 boys are there and number of girls is equal to 50. Okay, number of boys is 25, girls is 15, and I want to find out the percentage of boys, percentage of girls in that class. So actually boys, number of boys divided by total strength of the class. Whenever you are calculating percentage, out of total only you have to take into 100. Number of boys is 25. Total strength of the class is boys plus girls. So 25 plus 15. How much you will get? 40 into 100. So 0, 0 will get cancelled. Okay, do one thing. Here I'll take 35 and 15. Then 35 plus 15 is equal to 50. Yes. So 0, 0 will get cancelled. 5 ones are 5 twos are. 35 twos are 70% of boys are there in that class. Remaining percentage of girls means 100 minus 70, 30% of girls are there in the class. So we will see girls by total strength into 100. Girls 15 out of 50 students into 100, which is equal to 51s are 52s are. 15 twos are 30%. Okay. And just listen, the questions given related to marks. How you are calculating the percentage of marks? Scored marks by total marks. See, actually, if you want to know your marks, how you will get your marks? 24 out of 25. First, suppose total marks 25, out of total marks you are getting 24. Then how you will write 24 by 25? Yes or no? 24 marks out of 25 marks. And I want percentage marks. These 24 scored marks. 25 is for how many marks you scored 24? 25. So scored marks by total marks into 100. If you are multiplying with 100, then it will become as a percentage. So percentage of marks is equal to scored marks by total marks into 100. So like that, only one more formula also we have, percentage change. That may be increment or decrement. Changed value by actual value into 100. So depending on that, this one also we have done problems in yesterday's class only. Okay. And exercise 4 problems. All those are examples for percentages only. And all the example problems, whatever is given. So all those are examples for percentages. And tomorrow we will see some more extra problems on these topics. Ratio, proportion.